Moody Watchers Productions, your aviation channel for the best plane spotting videos in southern and northern Georgia. God bless the USA. Moody Air Force Base, MYNFT, home of the 23rd Wing of your Air Combat Command, the famous and mighty the Flying Tigers.
commander of the 71st Rescue Squadron. Other crew members on the sortie include Captain Kimberly Highsmith is the navigator, Staff Sergeant Nate Backer is the flight engineer, Staff Sergeant Joe Siegler is the radio operator, Staff Sergeants Jeffrey Gonzalez and Michael Mendez is the loadmasters. Also on board today, the two crew chiefs, Staff Sergeant Wesley Shearer,
en route to the objective area from long distance. Normally, the first aircraft, King-7-9, would be overhead conducting its job of locating, authenticating, supporting the survivor, while King-7-1 refuels the HH-60s, call sign valid. For today's purposes, King-7-9 is off to the north preparing to fulfill the Guardian Angel team, because the situation dictates immediate medical care for the survivor. Normally, helicopter air-to-air refueling is done at an altitude of 1,000 feet above ground level in training. The crews may be called upon to perform this delicate maneuver at lower altitudes should the threat or performance of the aircraft dictate otherwise. Helicopter air-to-air refueling requires a higher level of skill. Both aircraft operate in standard conditions for all purposes. Today's passing will be in just a few minutes, King-7-9 will approach from the north to conduct the airdrop and Guardian Angel personnel.
I got in trouble there.
Now please direct your attention directly overhead. And here comes King-7-9. For today's purposes, he was called in to drop a simulated bundle to assist the pararescue men caring for the simulated survivor. Formation has passed, and it will break up and recover single shift to runway 18. Each plane will be flying a random shallow beam approach and executing a maximum effort landing procedures. They make their left-hand brake to recover on runway 18. Disregard, they make their right-hand brake to recover runway 36. Looks like they're going to recover runway 18 after all.
Listen to your phones.
Goofy did that.
Here comes King 7-9 for his maximum effort win. Here comes King 7-9 for his maximum effort win. For the random shallow beam. King 7-1 has been granted landing clearance, and this will be the last HC-130P landing in Moody Air Force Base. King 7-1 has been granted landing clearance, and this will be the last HC-130P landing in Moody Air Force Base.
all you do is print touch the screen.
Thank you. Ready?
Yeah. Flaps.
There's Fred, the autopilot.
Yeah, there's Joe.
They look so comfortable.
They're not.
They've got these like sharp.
They're not. Believe me.
Soft cushion.
When you're sitting up here for a couple minutes, yeah. But when you're flying for like 20 hours, no.
No.
Up here, that's how you get to the top of the plane.
Wow, how did you remember all these?
You do.
Yeah, one of these bases is up here, you can't miss. There's your airspeed, your altimeter. Yep. Just looking at it, I remember. Just looking at it. Yeah, here's my, you just got used to it. I mean, yeah, I could get on here now and fly it. I mean, that, wow, yeah. It's been so many years. And then I pre-flighted half the stuff over there.
Yeah.
Here's your coffee.
My goodness.
Yeah.
Here's your coffee
place.
Your what?
The coffee.
Coffee. Hey, coffee.
It makes coffee?
No, you got it from the flake.
Yeah.
Here's our little oven thing.
All right, here, I'm going to get a little
yeah. Sorry.
Excuse me. It's all right.
A little oven.
I know it's hot up here.
Yeah, Jamie's got a microwave, remember?
Oh, yeah. I know about that.
What'd you do with my purse?
Yeah, all right. Refrigerator.
Fred, you never say anything about a refrigerator.
Well, we had to do it to keep all the IVs cold.
Oh, the IVs. Right.
Here's the button that saved my life in the war.
Remember when that missile was coming at us?
And it was frying.
Yeah, that was welcome.
You see the weight now?
Yeah, both of y'all getting out, come down and take a picture together. Yes, easy, until take a picture. Yeah, give me a second, I'll come down. Under further review, 4852 will now be down as Lone Wolf. Angel of Mercy, 5725.
coming. This is a great event. I want to make sure that everybody had a good time. And I know it was hot out there. We were dealing with some issues as we were flying around. So I thank you for your patience for that. Everybody that got to see the demonstration today. It took a lot of hard work. We have some people I'd like to recognize that helped us out getting this going. Captain Mike Smith, wherever you're at, raise your hand, jump up and down, stand up.
You know, I started out as a B-model guy, and I like the time. I know most of you, maybe not some of the older folks in the room. I went on several deployments to a number of locations, and I missed several of the more critical ones as well. Pakistan, Iraq, we've been in Uzbekistan, we've been in Hova, of course, Gower Towers. We were in Colombo, Greece. We were in Trapani, Italy. Most recently, we went back to Hova for a short stint. As the rest of the community, we're currently serving the Saikali Airport. So, King Aircraft continue to remain relevant in today's flight, but the full backbone was laid with the original H-130B, which, as we know, started service in Vietnam. Tim did a fantastic job of building this little booklet. Hopefully all of you guys have had a chance to grab it. If not, there's plenty of copies here. But there's a really good history of 71st to 79, and most of the aircraft in there as well. Kind of an interesting note, I mean, to give you guys some perspective, I think the oldest plane we had was a 62 model, if I'm not mistaken, right? 62. So how many years was that? 53 years in service. To today, I think it was 64 to 65. And each one had around 20,000 hours of time on the airplane. That's a lot of hours. I actually meant to do a little calculation to see how many days that was, but I mean, it's a lot of days. And, it's been reliable, crews have been reliable when we've been getting the job done, whether it's civil search and rescue, combat search and rescue, medevac, CASVAC, whatever we've been doing out there, preparation of things as well. The airframe has been reliable, and it will be missed. And I would also be remiss if I didn't mention the fact that, with the transition, we're going to be missing a couple of additional positions on the aircraft. Our airborne mission systems operators now, AMSOs, radios, and our flight engineers. I can tell you, with the experience of having being a J-MAL guy now, flying that aircraft is a lot of fun, but it's not as fun as it is when you have a full crew sitting up in front of the aircraft. Whether it's engineering, you're giving a hard time because you got the wrong response on the checklist, slapping on the shoulder when the checklist is complete. Or radio handling all the stuff that we really want to deal with, crypto and everything else, to make all that stuff work. It's been really wonderful experience flying with you guys. We miss you very much. But I am happy to say that we've been really successful in getting all of our engineers and our radios great jobs for great quality time, as I should say. For our engineers, it's been anything from C-22s, H-60 SMOS, KC-10s, a couple of college chases and a couple of retirements. For our radios, we've got NAOC, we've got data mass assignments, we've got E3, I think pretty much runs it out to those guys. So I'm happy to say that pretty much everybody who's leading the H-130B in those group positions has been happy with their following assignment. It's well deserved. We could have done everything we've done in the last 50 years without those guys. So, I just want to extend my thank you to specifically our radio and our engineers. We've only got two of each left right now, right? One radio in the room, Joe Siegler, and Nate Backer, and Kevin Stassis in the back there, for our flight engineers. I just want to ask you guys, can we get together for these guys for a minute?
One, two,
Kevin, put that on the back.
Hold on, just a second.
Stop.
Hold on, I will. Stop it. I gotta take a bunch of pictures, otherwise you guys will yell at me later.
Tacky.
Run!
I don't know what's gonna go. 10 seconds.
It's ticking. No.
All right, we'll just do one more. Stop it. Calm down. Ready? One, two, three. Stand by. All right, that's it. You guys are done.